The demand for data engineers is increasing day by day. Every day new tools are coming in the market and it is getting more and more confusing to what to pick first, what to learn. This is the big data landscape. As you can see, there are so many tools that are available in the market. Let me tell you, you don't have to learn all of these tools. You just need to focus on the highly demanded market tools and you can easily start your career in data engineering. So in this video, I will recommend you some of the tech stack you should focus on as a data engineer so that you don't lose focus between all of these chaos. So let me start this video by telling you that new tools in the market come and go every 6 months. So you don't have to learn each and every tool that is coming in the market, but few things do not change. It doesn't matter if you just started your career in data engineering or you've been working in this field for a few years. One of the most important things you need to focus on is getting the core fundamentals right. Two foundation skills that I always suggest for data engineer. First thing you need to learn is a programming language. As a data engineer, you will be fetching a lot of data from different sources, writing transformation code and automating some of the work. All of these things can be easily achieved using programming language. When it comes to data engineering, you generally have three choices. One is Scala, second one is Java, and third one is Python. So if you already know any of the programming language from this list, then you're good. So if you are just starting your career in data engineering and if you don't have any programming background, then I will highly suggest you to start your coding career with Python, because the syntax is quite easy and it will take roughly 2 to 3 weeks to get started with the Python. So the first thing is clearing your programming fundamentals, and the second foundation skill you need to focus on is learning about SQL, structured query language. See, as a data engineer, you will be working with a lot of different databases and try to query all of this data using SQL. SQL or SQL is the way we communicate with these databases. So it is really important that you learn Python and SQL from data engineering point of view. And if you really want to learn all of these things at one place, then I already have courses available on this. These courses are specially designed for data engineering. You will get around 6 projects total. These courses are taken by more than 3,000 students around the world, and they started their career in data engineering just by doing these 2 courses only. So I'll put the link in the description, so if you are really interested, you can check that out. Second skill you need to focus on is learning about cloud data warehouses. The role of data warehouses in the data engineering is basically at the end of the data pipeline, you have to analyze this data so that businesses can take the right decisions or businesses can take the data-driven decision. Now, one of the most important skill as a data engineer is to learn how to build a data warehouses. Now, there are many data warehouses tools available in the market, but as per my research and my experience, the 2 highly demanded data warehouses tool in the market is Snowflake and Google BigQuery. Both of these data warehouse tools are considered as a modern data stack. Snowflake has its unique architecture and growing popularity. Snowflake is likely to continue being a major player in cloud data warehouse market. And the same goes with the Google BigQuery. It is serverless, so companies don't have to manage large cluster and it can be integrated with any tool in the market. So these 2 data warehouses, I highly suggest you to explore and learn. There are many other data warehouses tools available in the market, such as Amazon Redshift or Microsoft Synapse Analytics, but I can list down hundreds of them. But the goal of this video is to give you the clear answer so that you don't get confused between all of these tools. You just focus on learning one tool, and as per my research and experience, you should definitely learn Snowflake database. Now again, I recently launched a course on data warehouse for data engineers using Snowflake. So if you really want to learn Snowflake from data engineering point of view, you should definitely check out my courses. I've already put the link in the description. The tech stack you need to focus on is data processing and analytics. Data processing is an integral part of any organization. Each and every data that comes from different sources needs to be processed properly so that we can find value from all of these data. Now, hands down, number one tool available in the market for data processing is called as Apache Spark. I already have the video on Apache Spark, so if you're really interested in learning more about this tool, then you can definitely watch this video after completing this video. This video will give you the quick overview about Apache Spark and why it is so much popular in the industry. Second tool you should focus on learning is Apache Kafka. Now, all of these things you see in the real-time manner, such as Google Maps or Uber, right? All of these data are being processed in real-time manner. And behind the real-time processing of all of this data is a tool called as Apache Kafka. So companies around the world, when they want to build a real-time data streaming pipeline, prefer using Apache Kafka. So if you really want to understand how to process real-time data, the good place to start is learning about Apache Kafka. There's one more tool you should focus on learning is called as Apache Flink. It is also used for processing real-time data. So the popularity of this tool is growing slowly. slowly, so you should definitely keep your eye on it. Now these are mainly open source version of these tools, so it is freely available and you can modify as per your requirement, but in most of the organization you will be using the managed version of these tools. So basically you don't have to install all of these things by yourself. There are services that are already managed by some cloud providers or some third party company that will give you the services. So if you are learning about Apache Spark, then you should learn the basic theory and get the understanding of Apache Spark. But on top of that, you should also learn the managed version or the environment that powers Apache Spark. So for Apache Spark, you can learn the tool called as Databricks. Demand for data engineers who know Databricks is increasing day by day, so you should definitely focus on that. So the important tool you need to focus on is learning about Apache Spark and the managed version of it on the Databricks. Now in future, I have a plan to launch a course on Apache Spark, so you can definitely follow me on this channel if you want to get more updates. Fourth is focusing on data orchestration and workflow management. Man, this is where most of the modern data engineering tools are coming in the market. Data workflow management basically means there is a data pipeline that needs to run at specific interval and at specific order. So in our data pipeline, it might be like extract data from some sources, do some transformation and load some data. So all of these things needs to happen in proper order and it should be easily manageable. Now, the tool for this currently available in the market and in high demand is called as Apache Airflow. So most of the data engineering communities and the organizations around the world uses Apache Airflow because it is open source, but there are many modern data engineering tools that are coming in the market that tries to solve the problem faced in Apache Airflow. So these are some of the modern data pipeline tools such as Maze.ai, Prefect and Daxter. Again, there are hundreds of tools available in the market. You don't have to learn all of them. All you need to do is learn Apache Airflow and learn all of these modern data stack and why they exist and what are the problems they're trying to fix from Apache Airflow. So if you just understand this part, then you're good enough. So you don't have to master all of these, just understand why they exist on the first place. Fifth is learning about cloud platforms. As a data engineer, you will be processing huge volume of data. Now you can't do all of these on your local PC. You need high storage and high processing power in order to process this, and cloud platforms make it happen. Again, there are so many different cloud providers available in the market, and each and every cloud providers has more than hundreds of services. You don't have to learn all of them. You just need to focus on 15 to 20 data related service to work as a data engineer. So as per this Gartner quadrant that ranks various cloud providers in the market, these are the top 3 cloud providers: Amazon Web Services, Google Cloud Platform and Microsoft Azure. Let me tell you, if you're confused between what to pick first, it doesn't really matter, because I started my career with AWS, then I learned about Google Cloud, and I recently explored Microsoft Azure. All of these cloud platforms are built on the same fundamentals. So once you learn one cloud, it is really easy to migrate to any other cloud platform. So if you are confused between which cloud platform should I learn first, just pick one and get started. Now I will give you the clear answer. Just start with the AWS. Pick AWS as your starting point, and in future, if you have to migrate to any new cloud, you can easily do that. So pick one, get started. I already have a videos on few data services you should focus on as an AWS data engineer. So if you want, I will put the link in the description so you can watch that. Six is learning about the data ops. Data ops is like DevOps, development and operation. The role of DevOps in the software engineering lifecycle is basically a software engineer can't develop the code and also deploy that on the production server. So we have the new field called as the DevOps. So basically a software engineer will write the code and develop the application, but there will be people called as the DevOps guys who will deploy all of these application in a proper way. The same thing goes with the data ops. So as a data engineer, you will be writing a lot of data pipeline. Now all of these data pipeline are written in Spark or Python code, so you can't just go and modify the things you need on the production server. It has to be done in specific manner so that you don't break any data pipeline, and this is where the methodology of data ops comes into the picture. Now there is no specific tool that you need to learn in order to learn about data ops, but just understanding this methodology and this exists in the market will make you better data engineer. Seventh on the list is learning about modern data stack. See, whenever any industry grows, new problem arises. Same thing happened in data engineering. As the field started growing, companies around the world started identifying these problems and started building their own custom solution. Most of the modern problems faced by these companies cannot be solved using the traditional approaches and the tools. And this is where, ladies and gentlemen, the modern data stack comes into the picture. These are basically the new startup companies trying to solve the individual problem faced in the industry by developing the new approach and the new solution. So these are some of the tools that are available in the market. Now I don't recommend you to learn all of these tools. You don't have to master all of these tools at all. All you need to understand is why this tool really exists in the market and what are the different problems this particular tool is trying to solve. If you just understand this, then you will be good to go. Okay, you don't have to master anything. So do not get scared by all of these modern data stack tools. So these were some of the tech stack that you should definitely focus on as a data engineering in the coming year. If you have any recommendation about the new tool at the tech stack that you are working on that I did not cover in this video, then definitely comment that so that everyone in the community can learn from it. This was all from my side. If you want to join my courses, then check the link in the description. I'll see you in the next video. Don't forget to hit the like button. This helps this channel to grow and reach more and more people. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.